Hi friends, welcome to GALDI's HEPGEC program. Here we are going to discuss both UPSC previous year questions and also model questions. So moving on to question number one on art and culture. The Nagara, the Dravida and the Vesara are the statement A, three main racial groups of the Indian subcontinent. Statement B, three main linguistic divisions into which the languages of India can be classified. Statement C, three main styles of Indian temple architecture. Statement D, the three main musical gharanas prevalent in India. So moving on to Indian architecture, our Indian temple architecture is broadly classified into three types: Dravida, Nagara and Vesara. The Nagara style of temple architecture is found in the northernmost part of India, that is generally between Himalayas and Vindhyas mountain regions. And the Dravida style of temple architecture was found between Krishna river and Kaveri river. Between the sense, the region between these geographical features. And the Vesara is found between the Vindhyas and Krishna region. So all these type of temple architecture has their own distinct features. For example, Nagara, then mainly temples are constructed around above up. Uplifted platform called Jagadi, and take example the Dravida style of temple architecture. They have water tanks along the temple premises, or they build high boundary walls around the temples. And Vesara, which is a hybrid form, that means it contains the both the features of Dravida and also Nagara. So when moving on to the question, the answer is, it is the three main styles of Indian temple architecture, that is option C. Moving on to next question on Indian economy. Which of the following constitute capital account? One, foreign loans. Two, foreign direct investment. Three, private remittances. D, portfolio investment. This topic is related to balance of payment. That BOP is divided into current account and capital account. The current account contains the trade account, that means the transaction of merchandise goods only are considered. And the invisible account contains the non-factor services, for example, the communication services or infrastructure services. That is called non-factor services. Next is the remittances which we received from the abroad. This all comes under current account. When moving on to capital account, it consists of foreign loans, foreign investments, external commercial borrowings, that means the loans borrowed by the commercial companies, and also NRI deposits. This consists of the capital account of the balance of payment. So when moving on to the question, it's asked, which of the following constitute capital account? So simply, we know that statement number three, private remittances. Remittances form part of current account. So it cannot be there under the capital account. So three should not be in the answer. So we can eliminate option A. We can eliminate option C. We can eliminate option D. So the answer is B. Just because knowing the one fact that private remittances belong to the current account, we easily arrived at the answer. The answer is option B. Because the foreign loans, foreign direct investments and also portfolio investment all comes under the capital account. Moving on to next question on Indian polity. Consider the following statements. An amendment to the Constitution of India can be initiated by an introduction of bill in the Lok Sabha only. Statement B. If such an amendment seeks to make changes in the federal character of the constitution, the amendment also requires to be ratified by the legislatures of all the states of India. We know that parliament has the amending power under Article 368 of the constitution. Amendment means the power of parliament to make changes in the constitution. So when a bill to be passed for the amendment, in the parliamentary procedures, there are many different types of kinds for introduction of bill. For example, Some bills can reduce only in the Lok Sabha, or some bills can be introduced in the Raj Sabha. For example, money bill can reduce only in the Lok Sabha. Also, when a parliament want to make a law in a state list, it must pass a resolution which could be moved only in the Raj Sabha. Similarly, when moving on to the Constitutional Amendment Act, it can be introduced in either of the houses, that is either in Lok Sabha or in Raj Sabha. And it's not necessary that the amendment should be introduced only in the Lok Sabha. So statement one can be eliminated. Moving on to statement two. If such an amendment seeks to make change the federal character of the constitution, the amendment also requires to be ratified by the legislatures of all the states of India. Please note down the term all, because it's an extreme statement. So actually all the states need not be ratified. Only half the states is required. That means if you have 28 states as of now, only ratification of 14 states is necessary to seek amendment in the constitution which is of federal character. The best example is GST, Goods and Services Tax. So, because it alters the financial relations between the center and state, so we need ratification of at least half of the states. Also, regarding the election of president, because the president is elected by the elected representatives from the parliament or from state legislatures, so it alters the federal character. So, in such cases, the ratification from at least half of the states is necessary. Okay, so the second statement is also wrong. So the answer is option D, neither one nor two. Moving on to next question on geography. It is a map-based question. Mediterranean Sea is the border of which of the following countries? One, Jordan. Two, Iraq. Three, Lebanon. Four, Syria. So, UPSC has a tendency to ask map-based question, mainly because these regions are prominent in the current affairs. So, we know that Syria is one of the most prominent regions in the current affairs. So, also Mediterranean region. So, because of this prominence in the current affairs, UPSC asks such type of questions. So, when looking to, this is Mediterranean Sea. So, when looking on the border areas, we know Iraq is little bit inside to the Mediterranean Sea. So, Iraq won't be there in the option. So, we can eliminate option A and option B. From this, one thing is clear. Lebanon and Syria is a border to the Mediterranean region. Also, when we make a detailed study into it, Jordan. Jordan is also located near to the Mediterranean Sea. So, Jordan won't be there in the answer. So, the answer is option C, 3 and 4 only. That is, Lebanon and Syria are the only countries in this question which share border with the Mediterranean Sea. So, the answer is option C, 3 and 4 only. Next question is on environment. Consider the following statements in respect of trade-related analysis of flora and fauna in commerce. That is, an organization called TRAFFIC. Statement number 1, TRAFFIC is a bureau under United Nations Environment Program. Statement 2, the mission of TRAFFIC is to ensure that the trade in wild plants and animals is not a threat to the conservation of nature. So actually TRAFFIC is an NGO which monitors the wildlife trade, and it is not under United Nations Environment Program. Actually it is a joint program of World Wildlife Fund and IUCN, that is International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. So, statement 1 is wrong. When moving on to statement 2, the mission of TRAFFIC is to ensure that trade in wild plants and animals is not a threat to the conservation of nature, and that's true because that's the clear objective of the TRAFFIC. So, the answer is 2 only, option B. That's all for the day. Thank you.